Well, as I was saying yesterday, we came across this workshop for making bells by the Sirepeju process, which apart from myself, archaeometallurgist Dr. Sharada Srinivasan from the National Institute of Advanced Studies, my collaborators from the Medieval Center and the University of Denmark are also interested in finding out with me how these bells were made. And I was here in Nachar Koil about 15 years ago, and I'm pleased to say that some of this still survives, the making of bells by the lost wax process. And we've braved bad weather and come back here to Nachar Koil today, where we've negotiated with the craftsmen and they've promised to show us some of the steps of the manufacturing of bells by the lost wax process. So here we are awaiting the craftsman to begin. He is winding the rope around the axle, the wooden axle. இது நீங்க ஏன் ஈரமாக்குறீங்க? ஓ, மட் போட்டுருக்கா? He keeps making the rope wet so that he can put the mud on top of it. இது இது என்ன மட் சொல்லுங்க?
இது களிமண்ணும் உமியும்.
ஆஹா. This is river mud. உமினா? தோ ஹார்டா இருக்கு.
ரைஸ் இருக்குல்ல.
It's got the chaff of rice. Chaff of rice mixed with alluvial clay and then he makes the rope wet. Okay. He makes the rope wet and then he puts this around the rope. As I said, the purpose of putting the rope is so that it will make the mud detachable. Sir, neengle panni kaatringa. Mr. Govindrajan is 62 years old. Idu eppal endu panninga, enga kattinga? Aha, he learnt all this from his father, who was a traditional bell maker. Avar kamalara, unga appa? Oh, you know, he is the last, this is, I see, in this whole area, he is the last surviving person making, knowing this process of doing it in this traditional way. So it's really important we document him. It's my cell phone. 1 minute. So he uses that to mark out the dimensions. Now Mr. Govindrajan is heating this mold so that it dries quickly. பழைய காலத்துல இப்படி எல்லாம் பண்ண மாட்டாங்கல்ல பண்ணுவாங்களா வெயில் தான் in the old days of course they would leave it to dry in the sunshine but now they are doing this to speed up the process using a blower and according to Mr. Govindrajan he is not so keen to take up this profession because he says there's not much you know prospects of income and all that which would be very sad because they are the last some of the last few craftsmen who are practicing these traditional techniques. Oh, Mr. Mariamman is mixing the grade of clay which is going to be used next on top of the mold that's being prepared now for the bell. For our benefit, he's showing us the pieces of the wax model and how it looks. So as you can see that at the rim the thickness is around 1 inch, a little more than an inch actually, inch and a half. And over here it's less than an inch, it's about 1 centimeter. And this piece goes on top. Mix it with this, it's called kungulium, powder of kungulium. And this is beeswax and that is melted together and heated and melted down and both of that is approximately the same percentage. So. Finger like a spatula to shape it. Kaiyodiya pandringla? He's just using, basically he just uses his thumb to like a spatula to shape it. இதுக்கு என்ன பேர் So what he's explaining is that the process that he just showed us after a sort of rough mold like that is made it will look like this. And after it has dried, he's going to show us what he'll do next to it, which is basically the application of the wax layer.
How long will it dry?
அண்ட் அது எவ்வளோ நாழி வெப்பேங்க ட்ரைங் பண்ணுறதுக்கு இப்போ பண்ணியது It takes one day to dry. Yeah. Now Mr. Govindrajan is going to put on the next grade of clay. First, the core was made, as we saw, it had been dried and it was shaped. And now the finer grade of clay has been put. And it is against this finer grade that the wax model will be put. This is fiber from sacks. So this fiber has also been mixed in the clay to give it good binding properties. Oh,
you're
the father, father.
Huh?
Small father. If you can see the line here where it's not joining, so he basically showed with the charcoal by drawing that line that it should really be finished so well that those it gets a proper circle around it. So that was what he was trying to explain. It's nalla circle. Okay, now he uses a piece of charcoal to see whether it is forming perfect sort of spheres when he turns it. And he draws a line to see if it's a clean line. And now, finally, we come to the process of putting the wax onto the model, and that's exactly what he's going to do now. So this is done so that he can gauge the thickness of the wax. I.e. he will build up the layer up to the thickness of this wax, right? And now he's sort of kneading it like a chapati, the Indian dough. So it's almost like he makes it like the shape of a chapati. Chapati at her clear. And he tells me that he's doing it like this with a heated spatula so that the mud can soak in that wax, can take it in. Because the first it has to get into the wax completely, the mud completely. So I think so we've been watching Mr. Govindrajan at work here now for the past, I think, half an hour. And I am just stunned at how amazingly skilled he is, the mastery over every stage of this and the way he manages to get this really silky smooth finish. And as the owner was telling me what's also really crucial, which he's a real master of, is the way he shapes the bell, because that shape, a beautiful, elegant shape, it's very crucial to the kind of quality of sound and the resonance. So it's all there in his head, how he gets the shape that produces a really good sound. And take one of the full view also, Full view of the man. What Mr. Govindraj has just told me is that the bell he is making is for a Hindu temple. For the Hindu temple, they put this flange around the bell. Rib. They put a rib for a Hindu temple. Rib in Tamil
Visri.
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 Are you
Hindu coil money? Hindu coil money.
Oh, I see. He says only if they put this visri, it becomes a Hindu temple bell. And if it's not put, then it's more like a church bell. Now, the reason as to why he puts the flange, it causes the Om sound, you know, the Om sound, which is very important to Hindu prayer. So apparently, only when he has that flange, then there's a deeper Om sound comes to the bell. So that's the rationale. So, that's the most elegant and beautiful wax model shape. So, and I want to introduce all our other friends here. This is Mr. Govindrajan, and that is his son, Mr.
Govindrajan,
who I hope he will be inspired now to take this craft. And we would also like to thank very much Mr. Anandan, of course, who runs this workshop, and he has kept this craft alive. Vanga, vanga. And this is Mr. Arivaragam, and all his other team of people helping out here. Ani, and நீங்க எப்படி இது ஆரம்பிச்சீங்கோ எல்லாம் கிராஸ் எல்லாம் கூப்பிட்டீங்களா உங்க நீங்களும் இந்த கமாண்டர் வேலை செஞ்சுட்டு இருந்தீங்களா அதுனா
இல்லை அப்புறம் பரந்து அவங்க பரம்பல இவங்க ஃபாதர் இதே பெல் இருக்காங்க பெல் போனார் அவங்க ஃபாதரோட ஃபாதர் கிராண்ட் ஃபாதர் பெல் போனார்
So he tells me that they have been following this as a hereditary craftsman, and he has been brought them here to work and stuff like that. So we have just observed this fascinating process of making from scratch the model, the wax model for a bell for a Hindu temple. And now it's about 5 o'clock here in Nachar Koil, almost sundown and time to go. And we've had a very successful and very exciting day. We've watched this model being built up from scratch, and he has shown us all the different grades of clay that were used to make the base base patterns and the base molds on top of which the wax model has been made. And very excitingly, we've seen how it's been finished to such perfection, this beautiful shape. And the shape is really what gives the beautiful gong quality, the resonant properties of the bell. Well, we may or may not be able to actually watch the casting because we are facing rather inclement weather now. But even so, we've managed to see the most of this very exciting process, which is in a way a dying tradition because there are not so many people who are following these very traditional methods anymore.